Hello everyone, in this video I will be showing you a demonstration on how to use Penzu. Penzu is an online journaling tool that is user-friendly and accessible on any device. To access the website, pull up penzu.com. In the upper right-hand corner, there will be an option to either log in or sign up. In this video, I'm going to simply be logging in because I already have an account. If you do not have an account, you can sign up. All the sign up requires is your name, your email, and a password. So I'm going to go ahead and log in. So once you have logged in, it's going to bring you to the front of your journal. If you are signing up, it's going to bring up a writing prompt as to why you are starting the journal. And in that prompt, it's going to also allow you to edit your journal and personalize it. If you want, there is an option at the bottom to completely skip that. We are going to be covering those things in this video. So if you're logging back in, you click on your journal and it opens it up. It's always going to open it to a new entry. So for instance, right now I'm going to give it a title. You're always going to want to give your journal, your new entry, a title. So for this case, I'm going to write post 2. So on post 2, I'm going to write, "Hi, I am making a tutorial." Penzu is nice because it does allow you to do a little bit of personalization in the free version. There is a free version, a pro version, and a pro plus. The free version allows you to do all of the basic journaling things that you might need to do. The pro and the pro plus allow you to do different types of personalization and export as a PDF. So on this, you can change your font name. There are 4 or 5 different options here that you can choose from. The rest are all on the Pro or the Pro Plus subscription. You can change the font size, the text color, and the background color. As always, you can make it bold, italicized, underline, or you can do a straight through. You can change the alignment of the text on the page. So you can put it in the center, right, left, or you can justify it. You can insert or remove a numbered or bulleted list if you choose. You can increase and decrease the dent or create a block quote. Up at the top here, you can make these functions go away by clicking the text formatting button. From there, up at, above the text formatting button is a button for prompts. If you click on this, it's going to pull up a prompt that you can write about. It'll bring up quotes or different questions for you to think of. So you can always hit new prompt if you don't like that one. So if you could control the weather, what would tomorrow look like? Tomorrow would be sunny. If you want, you can take away the prompts by clicking the button again. If you want, you can create a time capsule. So this would send the journal entry to your future self. So what do you want your future self to know? What do you want them to remember, or what do you want them to do? You have tags that you can put on, or you can insert an image. If you click insert an image, you can upload a photo from your computer or paste the image URL. I recommend uploading from your computer. So I would hit adding a photo, hit pictures, and for instance, I'm gonna add a picture of base 10 blocks. Totally unrelated to my journal, but it's the first thing that comes up. So I could insert the photo. From here, you can go onto the left-hand side of the page and click View All Entries. View All Entries is going to bring you to every single post you've ever made. So this is the Why Are You Starting This Writing Journey. This is the first post I made when I created my account. If you don't title your journal entry, it's going to name it as the date that you created it. So these two I did not title. So they're named the date. Here is post 1 that I created earlier and post 2. So if I want to go and I want to edit an entry. Say I want to go onto this one and create a title. I was playing with this and I was able to change the background color. So let's see, I'm going to change it to light green. And I could change my text color to, say, dark green. So from there, I can go up at the top and I can change to example. If I want, I can go back and I can see that I changed the title of my post. Everything on Penzu does save automatically. So if I want to go back to my journal, I hit the home button. From here, you can always hit new entry and take you straight to a new entry, or you can just click the journal itself. You can view the entries or you can look at the journal settings. So I'm going to click the journal settings. Penzu is nice because it allows you to change the cover of the journal. The first four options are free. These are the solid colors. The rest of them are available with the Pro or the Pro Plus membership. So if I wanted, I could change my journal color to green. On this page, you can also change the standard font that you want everything to be written in and the size. Page theme and the pad theme are not able to be changed unless you have the Pro or the Pro Plus membership. If you go to settings, you can add a new reminder. The reminders are sent to you via email to write in your journal. You can make the reminder every day, every other day, once a week, or once a month. So for instance, let's say I want to be reminded every day. You can change the time that you want your reminders. You can do in the morning, at noon, in the evening, or at a specific time. I'm going to hit in the evening, so every evening it's going to send me a reminder to my email to write in my journal. Now, if you don't want to have the reminder coming to your email, you can always delete it if you want. It's totally up to you. If you're journaling more for a purpose and you want to get into journaling, being reminded to do so can be a really nice help. Exporting, you really can't do with the free version. It is available on Penzu Pro. This just allows you to export your journal as a PDF. So right now, I'm going to just hit Save Changes. And then I can go back in and look at my journal if I want, or create a new entry. That is all of the functions of the free version of Penzu. You can always go Pro or use Pro Plus, but this video simply covered everything in the free version. Thank you for watching, and I hope this answered any questions you might have had.